Good afternoon and welcome to Performance St. Paul's at St. Paul's Episcopal Church in Key West, Florida. And welcome to our 12th week in a journey exploring the psalm, hymn, and folk melodies that have been used in the church through the ages and arranged for the organ. Today I would like to play some of my favorite hymn tunes, melodies, and texts that I have lived with my whole life. I am sure that many of these hymns will have similar meanings and memories for you. Remember, when we sing the hymns, we corporately proclaim our faith, hopes, fears, and dreams. As we know, the poet writes to inspire the reader. So when a composer writes a melody and marries it with text, he or she hopes that it inspires our souls to think, grow, and love. These melodies we already know for the most part, so as we sing them alone today, concentrate on the text, the meaning. Remember, music is a recreation. It is happening for the first time as we hear it and sing it. These words are ours. Think on this presumption as we continue today the hymns of our faith. We should not forget the importance of this upcoming Sunday's celebration of Father's Day. Inaugurated in the United States in 1910, this celebration complements Mother's Day, which started in 1908 and became a legal holiday in 1914. Interestingly enough, Father's Day did not become a legal holiday until 1972. I start today appropriately then with "This Is My Father's World." You will first hear it as a prelude set by Robert Powell, followed by one stanza of the hymn tune of Terra Beata. Unfortunately, our 1982 hymnal does not use this melody, but you are welcome to follow along the text from hymn number 651.
Thank you.
Many of you may not know or remember that I was baptized and confirmed in the Presbyterian Church, and many of my favorite hymns come from that tradition. So set to an old English folk melody, "Ye Banks and Braes," we hear the words, "We cannot measure how you heal or answer every suffering prayer, yet we believe your gracious responds where faith and doubt unite to care. Your hands, though blooded on the cross, survive to hold and heal and warn, to carry all through death to life and cradle children yet unborn." Our next hymn is "The Church's One Foundation." The hymn tune is called "Aurelia," coming from the Latin meaning gold, often thought as "Jerusalem the Golden." This tune was written by Samuel Wesley, who was the nephew of John Wesley, the founder of Methodism. He composed well over 100 hymns, as well as 38 anthems. Follow along in our 1982 hymnal, number 525.
Thank you.
descend upon our heart. Wean it from earth, through all its pulses move. Stoop to my weakness, mighty as thou art, and make me love thee as I ought to love. I will play one stanza on this hymn, and then a setting of this hymn to Nota's Morricone by Joe Utterback. Dr. Utterback is a well-known composer who infuses familiar blues, ballads, broadways, and jazz classics with a captivating dynamic style. It works beautifully with this, one of my favorite tunes. This next piece is a request from one of my favorite people in the world. His eye is on the sparrow. This hymn is based on Jesus saying about God's care for all creatures and inspired by a woman who has endured much illness. Charles Gabriel wrote these words and first sung at the Royal Albert Hall in London in 1905. I know that many of you will know the refrain. I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. For his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. To the refrain again. Here we go.
I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. For his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he
Precious Lord, take my hand. Lead me on, help me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, hold me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Thank you.
In the supplemental hymnal of the Evangelical Lutheran Church, With One Voice, American composer Carl Schack takes the word of "Thine the Amen, Thine the Praise," and sets it to a simple yet beautiful melody. First the hymn, and then a setting by Charles Callahan of the same tune.
Thank you.
Two more of my favorites, It Is Well With My Soul, and Now the Silence. You may follow along with a second piece in our 1982 hymnal, number 333. But first, It Is Well. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, It is well with my soul. Our last hymn today is number 522 in our 1982 hymnal, Glorious Things of Thee Are Spoken, or called Zion, the City of God. It is an 18th century English hymn written by John Newton, who also wrote the hymn Amazing Grace. The tune itself was composed by Franz Joseph Haydn. Because of the practice of singing the hymn to a tune used for other purposes, it has sometimes elicited unusual reactions. This same Haydn melody is employed in the German national anthem, formerly known popularly as Deutschland über, the third verse of which is the national anthem of present-day Germany. For some people, using this particular tune of the hymn, often known in various hymnals as Austria, is often controversial, as despite the fact that it dates back to the 18th century, it raises reminders of Nazi Germany. When I select this hymn tune to be sung, I'm always aware and deeply sensitive to those who have strong memories of those days. However, in looking at the text, the first verse tells us, Glorious things of thee are spoken, Zion, city of our God. He whose words cannot be broken formed thee for his own abode. On the rock of ages founded, what can shake thy sure repose? With salvation's wall surrounded, thou mayst smile at all thy foes. Composer and arranger Joel Rainey sets this arrangement as a toccata. Wikipedia defines toccata as, and I quote, from the Italian toccare, literally to touch, with toccata being the action of touching. It is a virtuoso piece of music, typically for a keyboard or plucked stringed instrument, featuring fast-moving, lightly fingered or otherwise virtuosic passages or sections, with or without imitative or fugal interludes, end quote. I would like to suggest a different text for today for the hymn, however. An anonymous 18th century English poet wrote, Praise the Lord, O heavens, adore him. Praise him, angels in the height. Sun and moon, angels, rejoice before him, praising him, shining star of light. Praise the Lord, for he has spoken, worlds his mighty voice obeyed. Laws which never shall be broken, for thy guidance he has made. All you nations come before him, earthly rulers and all kings. Men and women, parents, children, join with all created things. Praise the God of our salvation, who restores from sin and shame, heaven and earth and all creation. Praise and magnify his name. I will play one stanza of the hymn and close today's program with the toccata. I cannot thank you enough for being with me today. I hope that some of these hymns have touched your heart. I hope that someday we can once again sing them in church. For now, since we're not singing, keep these close to your heart and to your mind. Have a great week. Keep safe, and Soli Deo Gloria.